Hi, this is Mike. I'm making another video in a series of the playthrough through Icewind Dale and continue where we left off. And we left off at the temple in Easthaven. So here's the temple, and here's the main priest, and we get to see what he says.
Aspects. Warriors, true warriors, worship him as well. These eyes have seen battle, yes, and my skin bears the mark of swords and axes. That was long ago. Now my place is here. You are free to ask, traveler. I promise no answers. Jared was a shaman who lived long ago. He brought unity to the northern tribes and led them to victory against the army of Arakan at the cost of his life. Once Arakan saw his army routed by Jared and the northern tribes, he sought to bring the Helms to his aid. Arakan opened a gate to the lower plains. I do not believe that. Jared did. It is said that Tempest himself appeared to Jared upon the battlefield, and Jared took that as a sign. Jared believed Tempest was calling him to sacrifice himself for his people to ensure victory. And so he cast his body into the portal, his blood fusing it to stone. It lies entombed beneath the temple to this day. Jared had no need to sacrifice himself. Tempest's appearance was a test of faith, proof Jared's people had already won the field that day. Jared failed his god and died a coward's death. One dies for Tempest with a blade in one's hand, not by martyring oneself within the embrace of infernal magics. Jared's duty was to stand with his comrades, not cast himself to his death when the field was already theirs. Sacrifice? Let me say this of sacrifice, young one. Then we shall speak of this no more. Sacrifice is a death that has meaning. When it is in vain, it is not sacrifice. It is a waste. That is the lesson of Jared Stone. I, a great stone disc that holds Jared's corpse for eternity. And so I watch and guard it in Tempest's name. You are free to ask, traveler. I promise no answers. I have heard of it, yes. A messenger from Kuldahar visited the temple not long ago, and it has spurred Hrothgar to see what is happening in the north. Yes, a man from Kuldahar found his way to our door, and he was dead by morning. He claimed he was a messenger from the Archdruid of Kuldahar. The man spoke of disturbances in Kuldahar. His wounds prevented me from making any sense of his words. Perhaps Hrothgar understood more than I, for he's preparing an expedition. No, for my place is here. Were I invited, I would still not go. My injuries would only slow the expedition.
Okay, so I guess we should probably see Hrothgar next.
Agreed.
Oops.
Well met, friend, and welcome to my home. Make yourselves comfortable, but try not to break anything. Many of these curiosities that you see lying about have sentimental value. Are there all remembrances of my adventuring days? Little trinkets and the like that I picked up here and there? More keepsakes than valuables, really. Leftovers from my days of fortune and glory. Semi-retired, actually. This region is still untamed and fraught with many dangers. I've had plenty of opportunities in the last few years to take up my sword and shield and do battle with those who threaten the safety of Easthaven and its neighbors. In fact, I'm planning such an expedition right now. That is what I wanted to speak to you about. We've received word from Kaldahar, our neighbors to the south, that evil forces are stirring nearby in the spine of the World Mountains. I am organizing and leading a party from Easthaven south to Kaldahar Valley to investigate. You look to be capable enough. Perhaps you'd like to join us. What say you? I don't really know. The messenger wasn't too specific. I suppose if you want more details, you could ask old Everard over at the temple, but time's a-wasting. We need to get this expedition moving before the snows seal off the pass to Kaldahar. So what's it going to be? Are you in or out? Excellent. Glad to have you on board. I plan to assemble the rest of the expedition and set out for Kaldahar within a few days. With storms brewing in the mountains, I'd rather we depart sooner. But there are matters that require my attention here about town. Actually, now that I think about it, maybe you can help. Pomar, the local shopkeeper, has recently expressed concern over the rapidly thinning stock of his store. He's been complaining that the regular caravan from Caer Dyneval is long overdue, and that if they don't arrive soon, he's sure to be out of business. Now, normally I take Pomhop's whining with a grain of salt, but with heavy snows on the way, it would be best to make sure that caravan makes it through. I want you to find that caravan. Leave town by way of the South Bridge and scout the hills west of Lark Dinnershire, between Easthaven and Caer Dyneval. Caravans always stick close to the shoreline this time of year. Once you find it, see the caravan safely to Easthaven. In the meantime, I'll assemble the rest of the expedition and make the final plans for our journey. Return here as quickly as you can. We must make for Kaldahar Pass while the weather is favorable. Good luck. Safe journey.
Okay, so now this is the first non-Airbnb request that we can do here. Okay, I've got all the gear and everything that I need. I don't think I have any more errands to do in town. Now is a good time to save the game, just in case. You never know. Okay.
What is it you require?
Okay, I'll put on my basic spell protections.
Command.
Now I'll be the last one that I need. Okay, now that I cast my spells, I'm going to tell you what's good about these spells here. Okay, these are armor class spells. Give you like plus one or plus two to armor class. And saving throws and things like that. Protection from evil, which is this one right here. Gives you plus two versus evil. And it gets mind affecting effects. This is armor. Increases your armor class by 2 to 4 points or thereabouts. And that's basically it. And this one is reflect image. And this just makes it harder for them. They have to guess which one is to roll you, so it helps out quite a bit.
Speak your mind. Very well.
Okay, there's no furs for the wolves. And here's the more like the wagons that were lost. Okay. These are orcs.
God's grant me strength. shall be done. Speak your mind.
Okay, now I need to redistribute the weapons because it's filling up my inventory. Okay, I'm gonna save the game because sometimes when you sleep, you get woken up by monsters, which is not good. Okay, now let's see where we are. Okay, so I would usually let it run for 1 or 3 more minutes, but we're gonna enter a big fight, so I'll wait to cover that in the next video.